Hi again, it's Jason from Fraser Valley Rose Farm, and I want you to get it out of your head that spray is a four-letter word. Having spent so many years at the farmers markets, saying something like no spray is almost mandatory. It's something you have to say to your customers. And in fact, they take it so seriously. I remember on one occasion that a customer came to me so upset that he'd spoken to the apple vendor and the apple vendor had confessed that he'd done some spraying. And after it was all done, I consoled him a little. I went over and talked to the apple vendor and said, "What are you spraying with that upset him so badly?" And he said, "Well, it's a mix of kelp meal, neem oil, and molasses that I've been using with good results." Now, I have no idea whether that mix works well on apples as a holistic remedy, but clearly nothing in there is a health risk or a problem. So spray is just a method of application. Really what you should be looking at is what are you putting into the spray and is it appropriate? Does it promote the health of the plant or the health of the fruit or the vegetable without causing impacts to the healthiness of the food or adding chemicals to your customer's diet or garden? So that's what I want to talk about today, is a spray that I'm using with some success. I've been using, and I've told you before on this, that I use potassium bicarbonate, which is just baking soda. It's a potassium salt that seems to stimulate an immune response in your plants towards fungal pathogens. Particularly in my case, I'm talking about black spot and powdery mildew. Although I will link a couple of studies here below, the first of which will talk about, and in this case he used tomatoes, how it worked against a wide range of pathogens, fusarium and other things. So, you know, the results of this are well proven and the harms are negligible. It really is a short-lived, low residue, no harm product. Now, I do have a secret ingredient that I've added to that, and it may be one that you've never heard before. This one is called chitosan. Now, chitosan is another biopesticide. This one is made from the sugars in shellfish shells, and it boosts the effectiveness of these potassium salts, either potassium bicarbonate or potassium sorbate, both of which I intend to use this year. And it can boost them from an efficacy of reducing, say, powdery mildew. In the one study that I saw, the potassium bicarbonate might drop it by about 50%. With this added to the mix, it was proven to reduce it up to 70 or 80% in one application, and more with multiple applications. It does give you some idea of how I evaluate supplements like these. You hear about all sorts of wonder supplements, things you can add or use, and you know they'll cure everything or cure all, but you really have to wait for the science to come in and look up those sources. Okay, I'm going to use my handy dandy cart sprayer that you see behind me here. I hope you can see it behind me here in this video, and I'm going to show you how to mix this and how to apply this and why I'm applying it to my roses. I'm going to start with the why here, and particularly why I'm spraying sort of midwinter here. You can see that a lot of my roses held their foliage into the winter, but we had a cold snap. And what you can see in these leaves, I'm going to try to focus on some here, that have kind of an olivey looking color, brownish, starting to senesce. That's because they got hit by that cold temperature, and those are in the process of dropping. You can see also that there's lots of flowers that were held on these over the winter, and that's prime material for fungal pathogens to move in, things like botrytis and other rot organisms. What I can also see on this one over here, I'm going to give it a second to focus, is that I see signs on here of powdery mildew, and that's a cool season kind of a pathogen as well, or at least a moist season pathogen, and I really don't want that to carry over on these plants into the spring. So what I'll be doing with these to some degree is I'll be defoliating them, but I also want to combine that with spraying, and spraying to prevent a wide range of pathogens like that botrytis I mentioned and like that powdery mildew from spreading as they put on new growth going into the spring. If you're curious, this is a heated bench setup indoors that I'm setting up for my seedlings. That video will be coming. But I wanted to show you with these ingredients here for my spray, I may as well spill all of my secrets here. If you don't need to get these at the horticulture store at 40-pound bags, what you can do is you can go to the wine-making suppliers. Both chitosan and potassium bicarbonate, and in fact, potassium sorbate, which I mentioned as well in this video and will be in that study. All three of those are common in winemaking, and they sell them in smaller sizes that would be useful for home gardeners. So here on the left is the chitosan powder, and here on the right is the potassium bicarbonate, both purchased from winemaking suppliers. Now, the ingredients on this, and I have to admit, this is far, far easier in metric than in imperial. 0.75 grams per liter of chitosan in weight per volume, and in the potassium bicarbonate, that's 3.0 grams per liter. Okay, let me show you what that looks like in real life. What I'm mixing is a water solution, my sprayer. I'm mixing up 20 liters, so that works out that I need, if I'm doing 0.75 grams per liter, turns out that I need 15 grams of the chitosan. So I'm just going to keep on scooping from the bag here until I see the scale says 15 grams. And that should do it. As for the potassium bicarbonate, I'm mixing it at 3 grams per liter. So what I actually need is 60 grams. So I may as well just start pouring. And I went a tiny bit over there, but that should be fine. So it's really tricky trying to work this out to a teaspoons per gallon because this one is so much fluffier than this one here. So even though the grams per liter measurements on this is much, much lower, what it worked out to just in rough numbers is you had to put in about a heaping teaspoon of chitosan and about 2 teaspoons of the baking soda to get 1 gallon of solution. That's what it kind of worked out to for me. Obviously far more accurate doing it in grams per liter and weighing it into your solution. Well, I have the hose here filling the tank sprayer with water. Up to the 20 liter mark, I'm going to include the dry ingredients while it's mixing. Happily, both of these, the chitosan and the potassium bicarbonate, dissolve readily in water, so it shouldn't be too hard to keep them mixed up. And I've put just a drop of surfactant in there to help spread and stick the spray. You could use a drop of dish soap in replacement at home, but I've used professional type of surfactant. Alright, just going to fill that up to 20 liters, then we'll start spraying. This portable sprayer, by the way, is super handy for me. It just hooks up to a regular car battery, which I have an extra one over here that it's hooked onto. I turn it on and it creates the pressure for my spraying. So I can do a fairly large volume of spraying without having to use a backpack sprayer or pump things. Very handy for me, and it mounted really nicely onto one of my gorilla carts so I can just take it to where I need it, even out in the field with my roses or to each and every one of the greenhouses. This sprayer provides for a nice fine spray, so you can see that I move up and down and around the entire canopy trying to get the tops and the bottoms of the leaves. The point I'm spraying to is the point of runoff. So you should have enough liquid on the leaves so it's dripping down into the soil below it. That's when you know you have enough liquid on there. Now, you'll also notice that I'm not wearing any ventilator, any eye protection, or any gloves. That's because these ingredients are not harmful to humans in the amounts that I've mixed them. So there's no risk to me, and I wouldn't use something on my farm that's such a harsh chemical that it requires protection or I felt was a risk to my family. All right, thanks so much for watching today, and if you have any questions about this or other topics related to spraying or pest control, please drop those into the comments below the video and I'll see what I can do to help.